Bell and Circuit here for a beat breakdown of the beat I made a couple of weeks ago. Link in the descriptions, of course. The full beat will be linked as well on my SoundCloud account. And today we're gonna go through how I put the samples into some sort of coherent space that could be roughly considered a song. So let's get started. We are in Ableton. First thing to talk about is the ambience that goes throughout the entire song. These were made pretty much just sampled straight from this post-rock record, and I used stuff from different places, different samples, panned hard left and right with no processing really other than some reverb and delay on a send. But these things just kind of ebb in and out and go throughout the song. Different sections will have different pieces of this ambient going. So that stuff is just running in the background. The next thing we can look at is the drums. I created a drum rack and I put the snare samples that I got from this rock record. So those are two different snare samples. The snare samples were filtered and EQ'd so that we get something quite a bit higher. If we take the filter off, you can hear. Then I attempted to create a kick drum based on one of the snares. And in that case, again, we filtered it and transposed it, made it somewhat kicky. However, it didn't have enough oomph for me, so I basically layered in a kick sample from stock from Ableton, a 707 kick. And basically, they're just layered on top of each other. Except for some of the parts where I don't layer it, you end up getting sort of a tom type sound. So that was kind of a happy accident, and I like to roll with those. The other thing you'll notice is that this beat here that I have underneath the main winds sample is swung. And basically I extracted the groove from the winds sample, so it's swung off the beat slightly. I didn't do that on the other parts, and I kind of like how you get a lurch when you go back to it. So right here, when it comes back in, you get that kind of a seasick lurch because it's going from straight time to swung time, and it wasn't intentional immediately, but I liked it quite a bit. Let's look at some of the percussion. So we have this riser that I made out of a cymbal swell, the kids' record, I believe. And then we have this fill, drum fill, that I use for transitioning in a lot of parts as well. So I've got this feedback from guitar ambience, and I'm just using it more like a riser in certain places. So my original intention was to put, you know, the fills and the risers and all this stuff on it. But there were a couple spots where I wanted both a riser and a fill, or the feedback and the fill. And so sometimes I will just try dropping those things onto other tracks and seeing what happens based on like what the level is and what the processing is, what the EQ and stuff like that is. And sometimes you can get some interesting things unintentionally. The other thing you'll notice is that both the riser and the kick drum have some of the ambience. So you hear the melodic content where it came from the record, and that's okay. Just gives it more character. That's part of what the whole sampling game is all about. So the main sample that this starts out with is woodwinds. And then we also have bells over here. So both of these use this halftime plugin, which apparently is pretty popular with hip-hop producers. The cool thing about it is you can mess around with slowing down the sample, but then you can mix it back in with the original sample itself. And so for example, with the bells here, if we turn that off, so just by playing around with it, you get something pretty unique. I believe also the sample was detuned, this one by 3 semitones. I believe this one was more, 6 semitones, but the same halftime settings happened to work on both, and I just kept them. There is quite a bit of guitar going on. This first guitar track is pretty straight. It's EQ'd, it's pitched slightly, 2 semitones up, but not really, it's pretty straight, not really too much being done with it. Or this one either. For the bass sound, I took a guitar track and pitched it way down. So it was originally something like this. So pitching it down by 15 semitones gives you something like this. And then it's EQ'd pretty heavily just to skew towards the bass end. And then I am compressing it and side chaining it to the drums. And you get not really a bass sound, but a nice low end rumble, which I thought fit with the sort of orchestral epic sound that was going on. The piano sample came off this New Age record, and it originally sounded something like this. Originally, I had that, and then I would have it switch to a version that was pitched down and then run through halftime as well. So something like this. I ended up not using the original one at all because I didn't like it. Layered underneath that is this kind of synthy sounding thing. You'll see it's named Squeal because I took guitar squeal, threw it into a simpler, and made an instrument out of it. Put some Valhalla super massive reverb on there, which I quite like, and voila, we ended up with a synth. That's a quick beat breakdown. Tune in next week. This beat, as well as all my beats, will be on my SoundCloud account. That's linked in the description below. See you soon.